Good morning, Arizona students. Welcome to the HYFN-TV Morning Show. I'm AB, filling in for Jay Will. You guys ready?
I'm Ashley Cruz, ready to bring you into the weekend. I'm ready.
And I'm Tiff. Thanks for joining us with HYFN-TV Morning News, where we stay ready.
We want to thank you, viewers, for joining us this morning on the HYFN-TV network. Thank you for starting your morning with us. At HYFN-TV, we are broadcasting to schools all over Arizona. It is our mission to bring relevant, informative, and educational news to you, so you know what's happening in your corner of the world.
Big news happened at our nation's capital last night with the threat of a government shutdown. President Joe Biden on Thursday evening signed a deal that the House and Senate passed earlier in the day to avoid a government shutdown that would have affected hundreds of thousands of federal workers and would have slammed an economy that is still struggling to recover from the pandemic. This happened with just hours left to stave off a crisis. Under the deal announced by Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer, senators deleted a handful of Republican amendments and then approved the bill with a 65 to 35 floor vote. This temporary funding bill not only averts a shutdown until December 3rd, but also includes a $28.6 billion in disaster aid for states ravaged by extreme weather and $6.3 billion to further assist Afghan refugees. The House passed the Senate version of the stopgap measure later Thursday afternoon with a vote of 254 to 175, just hours before the government technically ran out of money at the end of the day yesterday. The bill does not include any provision to raise the nation's debt ceiling after Republicans steadfastly rejected any attempt to include it. Yikes, that was a close one. A lot was chopped out of that bill to make it happen, but budget and funding matters always tend to go down to the wire in Washington, it seems, as leaders in both parties negotiate for what they want. What's happening on a state level, Ashley?
Well, Tiff, there's plenty of political news in Arizona, but on this Friday, this next story is a real important one for you high school students. More than 93,000 people died of a drug overdose in the United States last year, with fentanyl being a major contributor, according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention this week. The Drug Enforcement Administration issued a public safety alert. This is the first public safety alert regarding drugs in 6 years because of the increase of counterfeit pills. Arizona is being hit particularly hard as about 6 million pills were seized in the state just last year alone. Officials said the state has already surpassed that number so far this year. In Pinal County, Sheriff Mark Lamb told Fox News they had more overdoses than COVID-19 deaths last year, but not every overdose was fatal. Their deputies now respond to a call involving fentanyl every 40 hours. Lamb said this team is struggling to keep up with the recent influx of illegal M30 fentanyl pills coming over the U.S.-Mexico border. And that as long as we don't secure our border, we will continue to see human and drug trafficking in this country. The most important thing I took away when doing research for this story is that these fatal overdoses are by large not just happening to hardcore drug users, rather teens that are trying to recreational drugs not knowing that it has been laced with fentanyl.
Yeah, that's terrible to hear. I mean, it's definitely an epidemic happening right now, and parents need to be watching, and children, don't play with drugs. Simple as that. It's Friday, which means it's Feel Good Friday here at HYFN-TV, and here's just a story to make you feel good. Like many athletes, the number they wear is very special to them. For 25-year-old Phoenix Suns forward Cam Johnson, he explained why he rocks the number 23 during the team's media day this week. Let's hear it straight from him.
I just on the radio, Psalm 23. Tell me about it. Like, how much does it influence your play, man?
It comes from my grandma. My grandma, she is a prayer warrior to the fullest extent. And she kind of told my dad to use this Bible verse as a prayer every time you go into a game, into a competition, into an important meeting, whatever it may be. And he instilled that down into me. So Psalm 23 has been a verse that I have always said before every game. And then I say it now during the national anthems. I've said it during the national anthems since high school. But it's the reason I wear 23. I was also a huge Jordan fan growing up. So 23 is a huge number of significance to me. And be playing at Carolina, I couldn't wear it. So when I got to the league, for some reason, you know, somebody had it, they said. But I was wondering, you know, maybe is it time to change it up? I had been away from the number for 2 years at that point. But there is no number that has the tie to me as 23 does, because of Psalm 23 and because of, you know, my middle name is Jordan. And I watched Jordan videos growing up like none other. And so obviously I had to go back to it.
That's so cool. Cam has always been very open about his faith, and he's extremely involved in youth charities and the churches around here and in Pittsburgh. It's so awesome to see athletes that are not ashamed or afraid to express their faith. All right, guys, stay tuned. The CAA report is up next. Are your sports and events currently being streamed by a quality network hosted in one place? Are your games, concerts, plays, recitals, special events, are they being hosted on the number one streaming network in Arizona? They can! HYFN-TV is free to the viewer with the ability to raise money for your club or your school via your stream. HYFN-TV has individual streaming packages built with the ability for booster clubs to sell advertising on their streams to raise money for their program. Stream on the HYFN-TV network. Go to hyfntv.com to find out how you can start streaming and raising money for your organization. Check us out on hyfntv.com.
Interested in becoming a student journalist? Join us at HYFN-TV.
Let your voice be heard.
Ask us how you can become a student journalist and share your peer story.
Your social media highlights could make the news. When you post your highlights to your favorite high school player, or your team out there doing their thing, hashtag HYFNTV, and your highlight may be used on the next newscast. You can get the photo cred right here on the morning news so everyone can follow you too. Every time you post a highlight on social media, remember, hashtag your highlights, HYFNTV, and get your highlight on the news. And welcome back. It's time for the CAA Preps Report. This week, the CAA football has been hit with COVID cancellations all over the map, so many games were canceled for tonight. However, the big news in the CAA this weekend is a Division I girls volleyball matchup between the two teams that met up last year in the championship. Ridgeline Academy will play at their home court against number one Holy Family Academy. Tiff, you'll be out there, right?
Yep, I'll be out there getting all the action.
Well, we'll have to let the viewers know how it goes on Monday.
Definitely. I'll be here Monday morning to tell you all about it.
Sweet. I can't wait to hear all about it. And stay tuned here, because next we have Ashley with the local weather report.
HYFN-TV is a proud partner of the CAA Preps Report. Catch all the CAA championship games on HYFN-TV streaming network.
Choose HYFN-TV and their crew to advertise for you. Expand your demographics. Get consistent advertisement and affordable advertising packages.
For affordable advertising with impact, contact us at hyfntv.com.
Well, it's October 1st, and monsoon season was officially over yesterday. And without skipping a beat, upstate Arizona ski slopes got their first snow. Check this out. Boy, oh boy, that looks cold. But down here in Phoenix at 8 a.m., we have partial clouds with a high of 76 at 8 a.m. Moving along around 11 a.m., we're looking about a high of 83 degrees. Later on today, we have cloud coverage of 0% with a high of 87. To kind of wrap up the evening around 5 p.m., we're looking at nice humidity of 20% with a high of 88. And that's the local weather news for today.
Looks like we have a beautiful weekend ahead of us. That's all the time we have for today, and thank you for joining us this morning. I'm Tiffany.
And I'm AB.
And I'm Ashley. Thanks for joining us this morning with HYFN-TV's news, sports, and streaming. Find us on your Roku device, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and HYFNTV.com. Bye for now.
Bye.